Welcome to Maker's Movement. I'm Norseman, and in this video, we're gonna install these two nucleus colonies of honeybees. Oh, man! Before we install these bees, we actually need to go get them. We ordered our bees about 2 months ago, and now we have to drive a couple of hours into Washington State to pick them up at the bee drop-off point.
Bees.
I'll help a little.
For your convenience, I put a whole gear list for beekeeping equipment via Amazon affiliate links down below. You can order everything, have it delivered straight to your house. All you have to do is find a place to get the bees. The first thing that I did was light my smoker and then make sure that it won't go out, because they have a tendency to go out if they're not being used. The smoke temporarily coats the receptors on the bee's antenna that receive the pheromones that signal panic or distress or defense. And this keeps the bees calm. Just to be sure, I wear protective clothing when I'm doing something disruptive, like installing a new nuc or pulling a lot of frames out of a hive. Now, I like to set up my hive so there's a nice workspace behind it so that I can work and not disrupt the flight path of the bees out of the front of the hive. I like to spray my new or empty frames with a bee food and hive stimulant combination just to encourage the new bees to use those empty frames. When you remove the frames from the nuc, remove them slowly and one at a time. Try not to roll the bees along the frames. It could kill them. Place the frames into the new hive body in the same order and orientation that they were in the nuc box. Sometimes it helps if you remove an empty frame or two on the ends and then put them back in and tighten everything up after you get the 5 nuc frames installed. Now your nuc's gonna contain a caged, mated queen. Just set her aside right now until you get all the frames installed. The queen is caged to protect her as the rest of the colony learns that she is their queen. Eventually, they will get used to her pheromone and accept her as their one and only queen. Remove the tape and then place the queen cage somewhere in the center of the hive where the screen part is accessible by the other bees in the colony. The worker bees will feed the queen through the screen as the other workers chew out the candy plug that's holding her in the cage. Whatever you do, don't be tempted to remove the candy plug. The bees will do this just fine, and your queen will be out and laying brood in a matter of days. It helps to finish the install with a pollen patty. This helps feed the bees until they get adapted to their new environment and locate their new food sources. Using a feeder with a hive stimulant is a really good idea, especially in the early spring. Feed your bees until they get adapted to their environment, they have a good, reliable food source, and they quit using the feeder. It is still getting cold here at night in the early spring in North Idaho, but the bees seem to be adapting to it okay. At the point of shooting this, these bees have been installed for 2 days, and it took them a while before they got active like they are right now. In fact, this is the first time that they are this active.
I mix my bee syrup to a pretty basic recipe. I tend to go on whatever recipe is on the bottle. In my case, I half the recipe that's on this bottle. So I'm gonna do 6 cups of sugar. And 7 cups of water. 7 cups of water, but I just use hot tap water. And the last ingredient is 2 ounces of beehive stimulant. And then stir it all up until everything dissolves. I have an extra set of feeder jars because it's easier for me to pour the feed here than take it out there and replace the jars that are there, than to try and fight the bees, take the jar, unscrew the lid, fill it up, and then put it back. They don't like that. Now do this careful because it can become a sticky mess and you'll get ants. If you splash it all over the place, you will get ants. Looks like we had a successful bee install. Nobody got stung. All the bees are happy in their new home, and hopefully they'll be very, very productive. For more on beginning beekeeping, follow this playlist right here, and I hope that I'll see you on the next video.